Hello students, welcome to online course of Mechanical Measurement and Metrology. Myself Abhishek Trivedi from Mechanical Engineering Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. We are discussing measurement of the screw thread and gears. In the previous lecture, we have discussed the different methods for the measurement of the major and minor diameter of the external screw thread, as well as we have discussed the methods for the measurement of the minor diameter for the internal screw threads. We have discussed bench micrometer. Then we have discussed the measurement by taper parallels, measurement by rollers and slip gauge methods. Today we are going to discuss measurement of the pitch of the screw thread. So let us start with the basic concept of the pitch measurement. Measurement of the pitch. So to understand the concept of measurement of the pitch, let us first of all understand what do you mean by pitch. We have already discussed that what is the basic concept of the pitch. Still we are going to recall it once again. Suppose this is your basic thread profile. Here we have drawn external threading. Now what do we mean by pitch? Pitch is the linear distance between the two crest of the given thread profile. We can say that the linear distance between these two points is known as a pitch. Pitch is also known as the linear distance between the two root the given thread. This is also known as the pitch. Now then, pitch is also known as the point on the one teeth, the same point on the corresponding second teeth. The linear distance between these two points are also known as the pitch value. These all are the pitch. So if we have to measure the pitch, we have to design such instrument that the particular instrument can strike on this particular point, and after the time frame it will also strike on the corresponding points on the next teeth. And once these two strike of the given pointer has been done, we are simply measure the position of the pointer. We are simply measure the reading from the pointer, and once we are getting the reading from the pointer, we can easily measure the value of the pitch. For that we have designed the pitch measuring instrument. The figure shows a basic pitch measuring instrument, or we can say pitch measuring machine. How this machine will work, we will discuss. First of all, let us understand the basic constructional features of the given machine. The machine itself contains the fiducial indicator. We have already discussed the concept of the fiducial indicator. The fiducial indicator provides a proper contact pressure for the teeth profile, or we can say thread profile. The pointer T has been provided over here. Spring loaded head is given. Spring loaded head is to maintain the down condition. We are supposed to provide the spring over the top of the particular head. So we can say that in the by default condition, the head has been attached to the bottom end side. Once the force has been provided, the head will move in the upward direction, but due to the dead weight of the spring, or we can say due to the spring inertia, it will again come back to its original downward position. Then the micrometer has been provided to take the readings as well as to maintain the teeth by teeth motion. Then the carriage assembly has been provided. Stylus has been given. Stylus is used to make a proper physical contact with the teeth profile, or we can say flank profiles. Then screw thread means whatever workpiece we are providing the screw thread. So whichever screw thread is used to measure, we are providing such screw thread. Then the two centers are given. The centers are useful for maintaining the conical screw thread, maintaining the conical screw thread in the original position. Then the base, or we can say the box assembly has been done, and the pointer K is given. Here we have provided the two different pointer, pointer T and pointer K. Now we are going to discuss the basic working of the given profile. First of all, let us attach the screw, or we can say the screw thread profile, in between the centers. The very first stylus has been attached, as you can check from the screen. Suppose this is your teeth profile, then your stylus has make such a proper contact like this. The stylus has been attached like this, and here your teeth profile has been, or we can say thread profile has been passed. So this is the structure of the stylus. Stylus will make a proper contact with the flank of the teeth. We can say that the stylus is making a physical contact with the flank of the teeth. Now once this particular position has been done, this particular pointer T will locate exactly opposite to the index mark. Here you can check on the screen, this is the index mark. The pointer tin must be exactly opposite to the exact indication mark. So I can say that suppose this is my pointer position, then the end of the pointer will exactly opposite to the index mark. This is known as an index mark. So once this pointer and the index mark make a horizontal collinear setup, then we can say that the stylus has made a proper contact. The physical proper physical contact has been generated with a defined uniform contact pressure. So this is the basic requirement. Then we are going to take the reading from the micrometer setup. Now we are moving our teeth in the forward direction. Suppose the next teeth will come into the contact. Again we are making a proper setup of the pointer teeth. Then the pointer will make a proper horizontal arrangement with the index mark, and the stylus will make a proper contact. Again we are going to take some reading. And suppose in the very first case, suppose the reading R1, let's say we are getting 10.25 mm, and in the case number 2 we are taking the reading of R2. It means whatever the forward motion has been generated, the same forward motion can be calculated over the micrometer. So we can say that we are supposed to find the reading of, let's say, 10.45 mm. Then what is the actual value of the pitch? As we have discussed that the pitch means, suppose this is the thread profile, then the point on the one thread profile, the same corresponding point on the consecutive thread, the distance between, the linear distance between these two points is known as the pitch value. So what is the value of the pitch? Pitch, we can say that the difference of these two reading, let's say point of 20 mm, this is the value of the pitch. This is how we can measure the value of the pitch by using the pitch measuring machine. The spring-loaded head permits the stylus to move up the flank of the thread and down into the next space as it is moved long. Accurate positioning of the stylus between the two flank obtained by ensuring that the particular pointer T is always opposite to its index mark when the readings are to be taken. Then we can say that the stylus is moved along into the next space by the rotation of the micrometer, and the second reading has been taken. And the difference of these two readings is the pitch of the thread. And whatever the readings are taken in this manner until the whole length of the screw thread has been covered, till we are doing such procedure and we are repeating such procedure. So here we have noted down the basic points for the measurement of the pitch. I hope you have properly understand what is the basic concept of the pitch and how the pitch measuring instrument will work properly to measure the pitch of the given thread profile. This is, we can say, a time consuming process, because suppose in the length of, let's say, 150 mm, we have a lot of thread. Suppose the value of the pitch of the thread, let's say 1 mm, then I can say that we have 150 different threads profile are available. So we can say that to check the particular thread profile very accurately, we have to repeat the same procedure for 150 times, and it is a very tedious and a time consuming process. So that we are not using such pitch measuring machines for the measurement of the screw thread in the mass production concept. We have designed a lot of optical instruments. The particular optical instrument is used to check, or we can say the particular optical instrument is used to compare the particular manufactured workpiece with the reference standard, or we can say with the reference workpiece. One of the basic optical instrument which is used for the mechanical industries to check the different profiles and to check the different dimensioning parameters of the screw thread is known as a toolmaker's microscope. So next we are going to discuss the toolmaker's microscope. As the name suggests, microscope means you have to make a proper setup which can magnify the given input in the magnification output. And toolmaker's microscope means it is very much useful in the tool room where we are supposed to check whether the particular given 3D profile is accurate or not, or what are the dimensional, or we can say what is the basic comparison with the reference as well as the manufactured part. Suppose this kind of comparison has to be done, we are supposed to use the toolmaker's microscope. First of all, let us understand the basic constructional details of the toolmaker's microscope. The toolmaker's microscope start with the support column. The support column itself is used as a structure of the toolmaker's microscope. Over the support column, we have attached the optical head by using the clamping screw. The optical head is attached by using the clamping screw. The clamping screw is used to provide the upward and downward motion of the optical head. Then the micrometer screw has been provided for the longitudinal movement of the table as well as for the lateral movement of the table. We have designed the table such that the table can be moved in both the directions. Suppose this is the top view of the table. From the top view, suppose the table is shown like this, then the table can move in the up and down direction as well as it can move in the to and fro directions. So we can say that the table is useful for the longitudinal motion as well as it is useful for the lateral motion as well. So we have designed the table which can move in the two different directions, and to provide such directions we have designed the two micrometer screws. The micrometer screws are used to make a proper movement of the table. The micrometer screw has been provided to make sure that whatever the motion of the table has been generated, we can note down the motion as a reading format. So we are providing the instead of providing the routine screw, we are providing the micrometer screw such that we can measure the total motion taken by the table. The basic light source has been attached, and whatever the magnification is done, whatever the calibration has been done, the calibration has been done over the table, and the magnification is done by using the object piece as well as the eyepiece. This is the basic constructional features of the toolmaker's microscope. The figure shows the basic working of the microscope. This is the basic cross-sectional area of the given microscope where the light source has been provided. The light source will directly reflect the lights through the lens over the mirror. As we already discussed in the number of times that the particular lens is used, suppose this is the lens, then the lens is used, suppose the convergent lights are falling on the lens, then the lens will directly make it as a parallel beam. Or if the parallel lights are coming on the lens, it will make a proper convergent point over the particular focal point. So lens is useful for making such kind of arrangement. So what we are supposed to do, from the light source, the convergent or we can say the pointed light source has been generated, and the pointed light source, the convergent light rays are coming out from the light source. Then we are providing the lens in the path of the light rays, which will make the rays of the light in the parallel directions. And the parallel rays of the light will directly strike on the mirror. Mirror is set at the 45 degree. In general terms, we are setting the mirror as a 45 degree so that it will directly reflect the light source in the exactly 90 degree to the actual path of light rays. So what we are supposed to do, suppose this is the path of the light rays, the mirror will directly deflect the path of the light rays in the 90 degree, or we can say right angle distance. Then the working table is placed over which the workpiece has been provided. The same light rays pass through the workpiece as well as the light workpiece as well as the table, and directly enter into the object piece. And through the object piece, it is also getting deflected by using the prism setup, and then it will directly enter to the eyepiece. And from the eyepiece, the observer can check, or we can say the observer can take the reading from the eyepiece. This is the basic concept of the toolmaker's microscope and how the toolmaker's microscope has been work. In this particular case, we are using three different lenses. The first one, that is a collimating lens, then eyepiece and object piece. We are using the three different lens, and the lamp has been set up. In the particular toolmaker's microscope, we are providing such kind of lamp from which we can change the intensity of the lamp. We can say we are supposed to change the luminance of the lamp. The intensity of the lamp has been changed by providing the variables. And just because of this, we are supposed to check, or we can say we are supposed to find a highly magnified image of the given screw thread profile. And we can compare this particular profile with the reference standard profiles, and we can check the error, or we can check the deviation from the manufactured parts, or we can say we can check the errors which are generated in the manufacturing process. So guys, this is the basic concept of the toolmaker's microscope. I hope you have properly cleared. You have already discussed the, or we can say you have already learned the microscope in the 11th 12th physics as well. as well as in the chemistry, I think biology biology lab have its own microscope which are not similar with the toolmaker's microscope. We are using the toolmaker's microscope with inbuilt light source, and this is the basic concept of the toolmaker's microscope. So here we are going to wind up our lecture. What we have discussed today, we have started with the basic concept of the measurement of the pitch by using the pitch measuring instrument, and then we have started with the toolmaker's microscope. From next lecture, we are going to discuss the measurement of the effective diameter for the external screw thread profile by using the two-wire method and the three-wire method. Till then, thank you.